You know, kind of like I said, after the game, we got off to a tough start, the opening drive for a score, and then fumble the kickoff, and they get it on the one, and that's a good formula for anybody to get behind like that to start. But we fought back and put ourselves in a position to have a chance. I think the sequence there in the third quarter where we threw an interception on the first play and then they drove down to make it a three-score game changed the complexion of that. I don't think you're ever comfortable with a two-score game or when you're about ahead. The three scores made it a little bit more difficult. And right now, 35 points in an FBS game is a lot of points for us to score. Let's face it, I think we're going through the process of finding out that it's not easy to win in FBS football. Certainly not easy to win when you start off behind 14-0 before you take an offensive snap. And it's just part of the process that we're going through. I don't ever really talk much about injuries, and I certainly never complain about them, but we were out three offensive starters Saturday. And for us, those kind of losses take its toll, as it does on a lot of people. Unfortunately, we'll get those guys back, but that hurts us when we lose some of our frontline guys a little bit. But that's football. You lose guys, and you have to close ranks, march on, and people have to fill in and do a good job for us. Certainly in no way, shape, or form do I say that cost us a football game. We lost the line of scrimmage, I think, on both sides of the football, and that was probably the key denominator. Idaho, on the other hand, is a team on film that is much better than their record. They lost to a good Eastern Washington team to start. I think they won the national championship in FCS a couple years ago. You play Wyoming to overtime and get beat. You play North Carolina and you play who's the other one? LSU. Two tough ones there. They finally got a win Saturday against New Mexico State and started conference play with a victory, which I think gives them a little positive vibe coming into this game. For us, this is the first conference game we've played since I've been here. Kind of exciting to finally be a part of a conference and get to play a conference game. Homecoming is good. I think these guys are talented. Statistically, they're misleading, I think. And their schedule may be the misleading part of that. They're much better on film than their statistics show, I think. We all have to take statistics with a grain of salt, based on schedule and lots of different factors. Some of them are telling them, some of them aren't. And I think in their case, they're a little bit misleading because I look at their talent and their size and their strength and their speed and their players. And they have good people across the board. I think it's a little better football team coming in here than their record indicates.
Talk about losing the battle on the offensive line. Adelaide's hurt. Zach Crawford's been out of the starting lineup the last 2 weeks. Do you think the offensive line has kind of maybe regressed since the Houston game and kind of struggled a little bit recently?
Well, we haven't played as good as we did in the Houston game, certainly. So you have to, I hate to use that word and say we've regressed, but we've got our struggles.
Coach, how much did you play the ball after the Houston game? Was this a preparation thing? I had so much time to prepare and so queued up.
The Tech game was what it was. We played good against Stephen F. Austin in a lot of respects. We had our struggles against Reno, but we got 21 points on the board, and we had some struggles certainly against New Mexico. I mean, we only snapped the ball offensively 21 snaps in the first half against New Mexico and got 14 points. They did exactly what I was afraid they might do is to grind the clock over and the ball keep us off the field, get us behind, and put us in a tough situation, a little bit like playing an academy team. We get in those situations, it's hard. part of it is the growing pains of our step up and what we're going through. Part of it is we just got to play better. I think we can play better. There's a lot of different factors that you think about.
So they turned y'all into more one-dimensional team in the second half. Coach, I had to come back. Coach, that what happened? And, you know, obviously, their running game, that's what they want to do, is take the air out of the ball. Keep y'all to feel they were successful. Did y'all feel some kind of desperation in the second half, especially with the pass and the first start of the second, you know, third quarter?
Well, I think the call, the pass and start in the third quarter was not any sign of that. We had thrown some quick throws and they'd sat on them, and so we wanted to either beat them deep or get them off of us a little bit. And Andy cut the route to the inside, and Sean, I think, thought he was going to be to the outside, and so we threw the ball over the shoulder, and the DB made a great catch. So I don't think it was anything like that. Now, once they take that and go down and score, the complexion of the game changes, because you know you only have so many possessions really left that count, and your three scores down. So now it's, you know, we can't change our complexion as a team too much. We are what we are.
That was smooth.
Yeah. Like when somebody, lesser athlete would have failed.
Fran, I think, correct me if I'm wrong, this is probably one of the games at the beginning of the season you kind of pointed toward, kind of a benchmark game, being the first conference game. And you kind of touched on it already. I wonder if you could maybe expound upon it. Where do you think the team and the program is right now? First year in FBS, heading into this benchmark game, landmark game. You had a big win early, but
yeah,
you where you wanted to be, or no? Or?
Well, you can't be 2-3 and be where you want to be.
Okay.
I mean, you know, that's an obvious answer. You know, where did we think we'd be in the season before the season started today?
I don't know.
We wanted to be better. We hoped for more, but we're not surprised. The last thing I ever want to do is to remind you of this and ever be thought of it as an excuse. But this is our first year going through this process. There's going to be some ups and downs for us as we do this. We have to understand that. I don't want to ever use that as a crutch for myself or our coaches or our players. And when I say that candid remark to you, it's only as a reminder of something you already knew. I'm not telling you something you don't know. We're going to go through this process. There's going to be some days that aren't as pretty as we've long been. I'm the worst one to tolerate that. I'm a pitiful loser. I'm a whiner, belly anchor, complainer, powder. I hate myself and all those things.
But you are very graceful.